Hey guys, this is Class Wars Preliminaries for January 2016. Got the usual setup, except the little addition of my Freya. And so this is actually a really big addition. Previously I almost always, especially in preliminaries, but I would say the most basic sort of standard setup that I would have was a Dark Sylph on my character, and then the Sylph troops would be Freya and Medusa. And as a side note, this is like the longest first round fight I've ever had in Class Wars, I think, because I think I even go into Sylph mode to beat this guy. So this is the, I mean, you know, I can handily win, but I was very surprised that this was my first round fight. And so I have Freya now, and that's a really, really big addition. Previously it's usually either wind and water as my troops, but really recently it's been two wind. It's very difficult to manage all the steals and stay competitive if you don't have a bunch of steals, because the awakening points just disappear. So it's much better to have two wind sylphs overall than a water and a wind, in my opinion. But water has its charms. It has a shield, it has the heal and everything, and so there are really appealing aspects to having a water sylph. And so Freya is just that magic. It's like Freya and Frigga, the wind and water merge sylphs, are the combination of all the wonderful things that you would have in a support troop. So here I have that group shield, the special, the one with the S on it. It's supposed to cover the whole party. You'll see in the fights later on that it misbehaves quite a bit, actually. And I notice it happens with the other players as well. So we're all sort of susceptible to the shield's not working very well. I don't know if it's a bug or if the wording in the shield is incorrect and it's supposed to be like one to certain numbers of players on in your party, but at the very least it will always cover my hero, and then the rest of the time, like, everybody else in the back is sort of like up for grabs whether or not the shield actually works. Regardless, still a really fantastic troop, and it's very nice to be able to have that steel in there, make sure that I'm gonna get the awakening points that I need, and also get some support, because when you're in sylph mode, you know, I have a dark sylph here, and the reason why the dark sylph is really handy in general is just because it's very sturdy. But you can use sylphs that are a little bit more risque, like Fire Electro or Wind Sylph like Ray does, and I was thinking about that, and so I did decide to go ahead. I was actually deciding long before this, as I was making Freya. I was talking to Robin and some of my guildies and crossover friends about it, and wanted to go with Wind to give it a go. But, you know, a Wind Sylph has been very, very difficult for me just because it's not super high power. People protect against it a lot. You know, everybody protects against wind for the most part, or at least everybody trying to go for first place. And so it's been difficult for me to pull off, but I felt much more confident with a Freya having that plan in mind. But that said, for prelims, I almost always go with dark. This is my highest BR setup. One thing I did, which I don't know if it affected my final BR in the standings, I think it might have, is that I put my Freya on both my kid and as a troop. I don't know why that's possible, but it is, and the game has not fixed it, so I just went with it. And so I have the Freya on the kid and as a troop. The reason for that is, it's, you know, I could put my Athena on my Eudaemon, and it would be fine BR wise, I think, but the set of gear is much better on my Freya, so I decided to give that sylph to my kid and use it as a troop. You basically just put the sylph into your set of troops, and then and leave the space on your kid empty, and then just go ahead and call it to your kid later on. Here's Christy, good buddy of mine, good player. Been making it into Warlord's Hall lately, but just not quite that upper caliber that tends to play for first in Class Wars. Has a dark sylph named Hestia. I don't know if she's either a fan of Greek mythology or anime. Could be both. I don't know if you guys have watched. What's it called? Is It Wrong to Try to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon? And it has the dumbest name of any anime on earth, but it's hysterically cute. And there's a new season coming out. So I'm really, really excited. Well, that's my one really, really geeky moment. And we can get back to Wartoon. But I'm really excited. There we are. My reduced res here is good. It's not finals caliber. You know, finals, if you don't go in with five experts, it's not just about your resistances against other people, your defensive resistances. It really affects your reduced res, because the later levels, the like last, I think 11 levels, 11 or 12 levels of your expert dimensions are the ones that give reduced res. The earlier ones only give the defensive resistances. So it's really important that you not only get your expert dimensions in, but also complete them. So I have a video on dimensions about sending some of your energy to mail. So you can do that throughout the month with your like less important dimensions. And then when you're in a bit of a rush, to make sure that you can get them done, you can use that energy from the mail. Here's my buddy Shay, and I see him quite a few times this time around. I do see Shay in prelims quite often. I can't remember the last time I had a prelims where I didn't fight Shay, maybe at least once, probably more like twice. And so I see him quite a bit here, which is sort of funny. He's got that new outfit on that just kills me. I just cannot stand it. I'm like, why is everybody's thighs in my face? Like, just, ugh. Anyway. Particularly the male knights. I mean, ugh, just too much. I just, nipples and thighs are just two things I just don't want to see in Wartoon. I hate the bathing suit outfits too. I'm glad nobody wears those anymore. Shay always seems to manage to do well against me. Like, he never seems to do anything in particular. He must be up to something, because he always seems to be doing a little bit better than whatever he seems like he should be able to do on paper. So we have a little rivalry going. I am on the much more OP end of the rivalry, though, so every time that he wins, it's like a really big deal, and every time I win, it's like business as usual, which is not as fun as being the underdog. There we are. Oh, no. Got him. And he goes with a standard setup. He actually has a water troop there. I don't remember if he ends up bringing two wind for finals instead. Here's Fear Tenenmar. Fear Tenenmar? Yes, Fear. And Fear, I mean, I think... Was he in finals this time around? Not finals, but Warlord's Hall. It's all a blur these days. A lot of new people coming into Warlord's Hall, and I feel really old when I feel like I'm like, I cannot keep track of everybody anymore. I think there's definitely at least one completely new face to, unless it was a name change. Somebody who I like never heard of, never seen at all in Warlord's Hall this time around. So there's that. Looks like he only has one troop on, so I don't know what's going on there. That might actually keep him out of Warlord's Hall if he doesn't fix that by the time prelims is over. And here's Asher, one of two fights with Asher. Asher's kid apparently has a very nice damnation skill, so that probably does well over 10% increase damage to me. In general, with the kids, you know, I do have my kid bring Centauria so that I get a Centauria heal, but I don't like to bring the single heal, and I do bring the group heal, but I tend to not use it unless I'm really in a pinch, because if you heal your kid too much or you heal your troops too much, things like that, you can get into big trouble when it comes to the timer wins. So here we both cleared the kids before we go into self mode. So kids probably not a huge factor. Damage to the troops is going to be quite a big deal, and he's got that Delphic coming. Big damage. And there it is. You know, the shield is supposed to be a group shield, and it only went to me. So I don't understand why it does that, but it does. Still managed to clear his troops, which is very important. But because I lost my Medusa, I can't keep up the steals very much. I do have lots of awakening passives on my dark stealth, or pretty much any stealth that I PvP with. I have some sort of passive for awakening points, and so I am able to stay in stealth mode for very long periods of time. So some people are asking, you know, like, how do you get that many turns when you're in sylph mode? It's all about the passives. I mean, here you need the sylph troops to support you as well, but even in, like, a BG fight or something like that, it has to do with the passives. Here, I couldn't believe that I couldn't kill him off here. You know, Odin just has too much damage reduction or something. It's like, I'm just... Eh. So close. But here he gets that Delphic that heals a lot, and it hits my troop. If it only hit me, it would have been fine. So actually, in that one case, I wish Freya had just died earlier. Big Delphic on me. I'm into sylph mode, but I lose on timer. Not surprised by that one, actually, as I'm looking back on it. You know, at first, I was like, what just happened? But he did get that Delphic AoE on my kid very late in the 100% bonus, and it dealt quite a bit of damage. So I think that really wasn't in my favor as far as the timer goes. And I was just telling Shay, you know, he's not happy to see me again. Probably if I had won that fight against Asher, I wouldn't be seeing Shay here. Shay's probably taken a loss to somebody already. And so had I won that fight, I'd probably be facing Ray or Chili or something like that. But instead, Shay gets me again after taking that loss. Into sylph mode, I'm a turn, like half a turn, really like a half step behind Shay. So it makes it a little bit easier to deal with the AoEs, deal with the troops, actually, if you're a little bit behind. You don't want to be too far behind, though, because then you can end up being blocked out of sylph mode for quite a while. Also, much better to be stunned in sylph mode than out of sylph mode. That's one thing to watch out for. If some people dawdle a little too much in class mode, they can get stunned, and it's much better to be in your sylph mode, have the troops supporting you and all of that stuff while you're stunned, than be stuck outside of sylph mode and taking a lot of damage. Get him with a Devil's Gaze there, and the troops clear the other troop. Devil's Gaze is player priority, so it's very nasty. It's a heal reduction, and so... very nice against mages. You know, I have considered making Odin. I have no plans for that in the very near future. I no plans for that. There's just no way I'm going to charge that many Balins again for a while. You know, I'm not saying I won't recharge at all. I just haven't right now, and I'm not in the right mental state to convince me to recharge. But, if I do make Odin, you know, previously I thought, oh, I'll give up Devil's Gaze and just go with a lot of AoEs. But lately, I mean, Devil's Gaze has played into so many of my PvP fights against these mages. And even against some of the other classes, because a lot of them bring Friggas and Water Sylphs and things like that. Devil's Gaze all of a sudden is one of those single target attacks that I just don't see myself living without. Here, my kid is still alive, which is no good. I have a Chaos on, so yeah, I just killed Panda. And used one of my AoEs doing so. It would have been better if it were like a Devour Soul or something like that. Not a huge deal, but clearing the troops, the sylph troops, sometimes takes two AoEs. The one Delphic doesn't always do it. So, anyway, not a huge deal in this case, but in general, it's much better to be Chaosed using a single target attack than it is one of my AoEs. And here she is, Ray 7. I would say I have to see her at least once every prelims, but I actually don't fight Chili Mac in this prelims. I think Chili ended up bringing Thor, and he took a bunch of losses that he probably, if he were bringing Odin or something like that, would not have taken. You know, he's just messing around and whatever, but because he took those losses, I guess I'm not seeing here as much. I think Asher, Ray, and myself are the ones with the fewest losses. And Rey is also suspecting that she would see me rather soon. So she tried to get a stun on me. Didn't, which is good. Means I can get into sylph mode and all that. And this Freya, I just, I think I mentioned to Rey, it's, you know, everything looks like it's behaving as it should, and then it just doesn't. You know, Rey's, I think Rey's big sis, the frigate in the front, is didn't get the shield either. So hers is misbehaving a little, just not as much as mine is. So I'm forced to get out of sylph mode, get a guardian rune, throw on the heal. And I was telling Rey that my Freya is a big noob because she only shields me. So my Freya needs a little bit of work. That's a big hit. At the moment, I set it up that I would have two wind expert dimensions this month. In prelims, I didn't change around my resistance crystals. I didn't rebalance them. So in prelims, I just have three of every single resistance. And so I didn't adjust anything in particular. I just protected evenly against everything. And then the disparities are according to whatever dimensions I have. I am a little bit surprised that I even made it into sylph mode here. Hoping to get one AoE out to get some damage. I don't think I do, though. Nope, there we go to timer. And somehow I get the victory. I have no idea. My troops are dead. No clue. So, you know, I felt that one just did not look like it was going my way, and it did. I have no idea. maybe her kid lived longer than I did. I forgot to look if her kid made it live through sylph mode. Like, into, you know, me using one of my sylph skills. So that could be a factor. You know, I always leave the kid on for prelims because there's no way that I want to drop my BR that much. But I often drop the kid for finals in order to push for timer wins more. So I was mentioning to Asher what the wins are. You know, these are all people that I talk to on a regular basis. I mean, Rey I don't talk to outside of the game because I have no... I probably would chat with her if I could. But, you know, whenever I see her in BGs and things... she's always a fun person to have a word with. But yeah, again, all people I'm friendly with, so end up chit-chatting a bit or reanalyzing things afterwards on Facebook chat or whatever. Asher's one of those people where I'm always surprised that he hasn't, you know, I think last month he told me it was his first top three performance, which I find sort of amazing because he always sort of pulls off something good, and I don't know. He just hasn't really found that magic yet for the win. Set up similarly to myself. He's got his Odin, just like a more OP version of my team. Has the Frigga and Odin, and then Medusa. I have Hecate, Freya, and Medusa. Need to get back into sylph mode. Sorry that there are little pop-ups at the bottom. I'm going to have to block those out. Just like little Facebook messages. I have no idea when those happen. I don't know what happened to my settings, but I didn't figure out how to get rid of them until after Glass Wars. So, bit of a mess there. Somehow managed to live through this. I think it does go to timer. Surprised I didn't get deflected or something there. And then somehow I won that. So he killed me too late, but I was obviously dead, right? Anyway, so I just robbed Asher, like a clean robbery of one of Asher's wins. So that was just silly. So the first one he won on timer, and then that one somehow I won on timer. I have no idea why, but anyway, that's what happened. Here's Miss Rey again. Panda just not holding up well. Rey's kid is just ridiculous. I mean, that archer hits hard. So, you know, depending on Especially, well, she has a, the kid has a rise on, so he should hit me pretty hard. I don't have a lot of fire resistance, but just regardless, that kid, I mean, that's, I don't do U Demon Arena very often, but I would not want to do U Demon Arena against Rey. Very, very tough. The shields are down, but I am out of AoEs, which is never a good situation to be in. I somehow won that first fight on timer and didn't know how. And at this point, it's a bit of a survival game. I'm not in a good position. One thing about the Freyas and the Friggas, you do bother to have so many support skills that actually, you know, the little hits just don't happen as often. You know, they're not dealing the Delphix or anything big damage other than the steals. And the kids, especially at the bigger damage bonuses, can actually deal quite a bit. So they're a bit less aggressive than a Medusa or something like that. And here I just have to live, right? I mean, there's no way that I can really do much else. It looks like I have a snowflake shield on, like that I have an absorption shield, but I definitely don't because I'm taking enormous amounts of damage. Trying to get an AoE out in Sylph mode. If I can get an AoE out, it's at least a nice chunk of damage. Rey's forced out though. And she wins this one on timer. So I don't know, yeah, maybe she just killed my kid too early? Because my kid was gone, like, first, off the bat. So here I bring Meteor, but as I was doing all these fights and stuff, I just was like, for finals, I was like, forget it. I'm not going to even bother trying to kill the kid in finals. If they bring a kid, you know, I knew that for finals, some people would drop the kids. And so I just made the executive decision that for finals, you know, to drop Meteor and bring Centauria, because I wouldn't be bringing a kid, so I wouldn't have that Centauria support from Panda. So I decided to bring Centauria myself and drop the AoE. That's for finals, though. Here, we're still in the same situation. You know, desperately wanting this Freya to shield the whole team, and she just refuses to. Just will not behave for me. You know, Rey was giving me a little advice saying, you know, you should go for a kill instead. I'm like, how am I supposed to kill anything? Because the moment, because I need the Sylphs, you know, I need Freya and Medusa to stay alive. And without that shield, they will not stay alive much against Rey. And so they're unprotected, they won't steal as long, and so I just get eaten up by Rey. I'm kicked out of Sylph mode very, very quickly, because she has a Wind Sylph and two Friggas. So, you know, would I love to be able to just kill Rey? Sure. But I can't use any Sylph skills, so. Not a great situation to be in. Really big hit, those steals do hit hard. Steel is a very high power. Steel is the single best AoE skill as of right now. You know, maybe the knighthood stuff, you know, in the new patch will change that up. But definitely out of the Sylph skills, hands down, steel is the best AoE. It's not the most powerful, but if you take into consideration the fact that it steals 500 awakening points for your whole team, each time, and then does like a 300% damage skill or whatever. Hands down, steel is the AoE in this game. And then I won that one. I mean, you know, same situation, both the troops are, every single fight it ends looking very similar. I have barely any HP, you know, Rey is alive and well, and her Friggas are alive and well, and I won two of them on timer, and I lost one on timer. So it's total mystery to me. I just, 0% doesn't make a wink of sense to me. And here we're finishing up with Shay. So, gotta finish up killing Shay. And he's saying that his two losses so far have been to me. I think he said he beat Chili in prelims, which, regardless, you know, even if Chili's bringing Thor, that's rather impressive. Either that or Chili was just not having a good night in prelims. I think Chile actually tends not to perform that well in prelims. He might just be doing whatever. Ray usually wins prelims. I can't remember the last prelims that Ray didn't win, actually, now that I think about it. And yeah, so the Freya did end up shielding my whole team against Shay, but then against the people where I really needed it to shield the whole team, it just didn't. So that skill clearly just misbehaving a bit, and I don't really know what to do about it. I'll probably just send in a ticket and tell them that there's a bug because it clearly doesn't, act as described. It's definitely supposed to shield the whole team every single time like that. But it doesn't. So maybe if the other side has a Frigga and a Freya, it like cancels out and takes away one of the shields. I don't know. I'm hypothesizing, but that might really be what it is. And so yeah, that's prelims. I was just, complaining about how the timer win seemed totally arbitrary. So here, a big congratulations to everybody on my server who made it into finals. Lots of them in here. I ranked third in prelims because I tied for 13 and 2 with Asher, Ray, and myself. We all went 13 and 2, but Asher and Ray both have more BR than I do. So it would go Ray, Asher, myself for prelim rankings. And then to my horror, I'm ranked 10th in BR. I haven't been ranked 10th in BR in anything Mage Class Wars related in ages. So that was totally horrifying. So I was looking at the wagers, and I was, at a certain point, I just always wager on myself. And so I ended up going with myself, then Ray, then Chili. But oh boy, I just I can't remember the last time I was on that second page on the BR ranking. So that was totally horrifying. It might have been. I'm hoping that it was just the fact that I put my Freya as my Sylph troop and on my Kid. I really hope that that's the reason why my total party BR is lower, because otherwise I'm totally horrified by everybody else's Sylphs. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Take care and have a very good day.